Ladies and gentlemen, starting this three rounds in a country bout. Introducing first, by out of the blue corner, weighing in under 63 kgs, by the out of Samson, presenting Glenn
the environmentalist. Oh my god, you can't see it on the stream, folks. Dec Larkin, despite having brilliant hands earlier on, he tried to get the butterfly in question. It's making a fool out of Noel and Dec Larkin. That butterfly is tormenting him. Just do it, Noel, just go for him. Why didn't you go for it?
Because the chances of catching a butterfly while holding a microphone and a card,
hit it with it.
You're going to look foolish.
You remember Greg Jackson's best line? No. George St. Pierre. Oh, I think I tore my groin. I tore my groin. I don't care, Mr. St. Pierre. Hit him with it. Hit him with your groin.
I'm not hitting a butterfly in my groin.
Well,
that's not the type of pay-per-view people have tuned in to see.
Dec Larkin, despite having amazing hands earlier on, he tried to grab it and nearly went on top of the medic. So I do see where you're coming from.
Now, referee Torres JJ in the black and green. Glenn Hardy is in the all black. Touch of gloves, we're on their way. Garrett Lyons, our third man in the cage.
I tell you, Dara has put a lot of work in training since the last event. Came up a little bit short the last time, but I have seen him multiple times a week at so many different sessions, putting it all together.
As you said, he lost that Euro Fighting Championship 1 via an armbar in round 2. Evenly matched bout, Glenn Hardy had a loss on Clan Wars 39. It was a unanimous decision against Rory Vecchia, so both fighters still looking for that first tick in the win column.
The maiden victory.
Nice work in real battle position and trying to get the back. Is Rafferty trying to get a hold of a single and maybe slide up the torso here? Is Hardy real battle for position? Potentially gives the neck here. Beautiful shots here and taking advantage. He's got the arm under the chin, but he's still on the side and almost front there. Rafferty abandons it.
Yeah, when you're able to get yourself back up standing, you kind of lose the threat straight away. That was an amazing, nice little arm control counter by Dara to get out from that position. I felt he might have fallen in love with the idea of it a little bit too much. We ended up getting two or three rotations of the same move. Just hit it one time, use it to break and get back into the center.
A little bit of your time in Dublin showing through there, the way you said center, Andrew.
The
center.
What?
Center.
Center. I'm on the town.
Nice knee by Rafferty, just spearing the torso of Hardy. Circles and gets away, lands a nice right hand as he engages in the clinch again and changes level, looking for that double. Hands not classed, they are now. And Reece Hardy away from the cage, excellent work by Dara Rafferty.
Straight to the mount, is it? No, kind of like a half guard now.
Battle for position, switching sides.
The position.
Good work by Hardy, retains, and looking for a triangle, posturing up high, looking up to the ceiling is Dara Rafferty. It's quite loose now, switching to potentially an arm. Pulls him back in. He needed to control that posture to set up if he is going for that triangle.
Good decision from Dara there. You either want both arms out or both arms in. You don't want to be sitting in that halfway neutral position where an armbar or triangle could come up. Glenn seems to have a nice guard though. He's not being flat on his back. He's cutting angles. He's moving on to either side of his hip here.
Yeah, you are looking for the arm, a switch there, but good work by Rafferty to avoid. To your point, Andrew, he's looking to attack. Rafferty needs to follow the hips a little bit of Hardy on bottom.
Lovely first round between both of these now. That's a good back and forth.
Any minute now, we will have our little insect friend fly into the cage. And Andrew, to that point, with the pay-per-view events, you know, these illegal streamers, they go to all measures. How do we know this is not a tiny drone with
a
camera?
It could be a drone. Yeah, it could be a drone. Someone is illegally streaming the event through a drone butterfly. Yeah. And we're we've all definitely been looking at animals at some point before, thinking like that could be a drone.
That could be a drone.
That could be a cat, like a cat drone.
See, in Dublin, a cat drone means like a cheap, bad drone. A cat drone. That's
okay.
A cat.
So obviously, cats can't fly, but I mean, like a camera.
Yeah. If there was a cat flying around the arena,
that'd be a bigger thing. Yeah. What did you take? No. But it is like, in terms of, we should be working for some sort of surveillance operation though, because these ideas, once you put them out there, like Zuckerberg will be stealing them or something.
Yeah, actually, he's listening to us, so he probably already wrote it down on his pen and paper. Here we go, second round, and there's a real close battle on the ground, both fighters exchanging and back on the feet here. This Rafferty who changed level gets a big takedown.
Great timing from Dara there. He landed two nice shots. It caused Glenn to just want to rush him a little bit. Dara timed it well, dropped the level.
That's a beautiful transition into side control as well. Used the momentum and just worked his legs across into that side.
And we can always appreciate a good slam. The only thing that he was missing there was actually like using it to walk him a couple of steps across the cage before slamming him.
Matt Hughes, Frank Trigg. I always make these references of Matt Hughes, Frank Trigg. There's probably a good chance that kids watching this have no idea who either of the people are.
Well, it was 11 years ago yesterday since BJ Penn last won in mixed martial arts. So, there you go.
Looking for this triangular potential arm here again. And again, you've Rafferty looking high. He's on the arm now, and this is tight. Using the knee as Rafferty to try and stop it, but this looks tight if he just can get the turn. And Rafferty fighting for his life. The elbow is still slightly in, but it's not extended.
See, he's using his right hand now to start to take the pressure off it a little bit. If I'm Dara
Rafferty,
that's a great situation to get out of there from Dara. Mentally, imagine what that feels like. You were beaten by the exact same sequence in your last fight.
In the
you
same
overcome
round.
That.
Yeah. Big moment, as you say, with Dara Rafferty. Looking to take the legs away here is Glenn Hardy again. Good defense so far. Hands are clasped, but a little high. Leaning his mass in.
He's looking for the right idea with this underhook here to try and separate the hand connection, but Dara's base has been good so far. It's a little bit compressed here. You'd want it a tiny bit more wide when your back's up against the cage. That's the only thing. Fighting the hands very well as well.
Hardy switches to the single and looking the corner, calling for a high crotch.
Now he's successfully set. You see, it's at that time you have to go. He timed that well. It's when you separate the hands and you have control of one of his wrists, that's when you have to go. This is a very good reactive grappling performance here from both.
And Rafferty is now sitting in the full mount of Hardy.
He might have an arm underneath the neck there, Noel. We can't see. We're blind here, no. Glenn's back on his back now.
Just got to be careful of the push off the cage. Ten-second clapper goes. So Rafferty is just going to rain down punishment, you presume, and put an exclamation on this second round. Hardy done well not to take damage there right at the end, but a big end to that second round there. As you said,
What a moment to surpass what he lost his debut to, an armbar in the second round. What a moment for Dara Rafferty.
Real big heart there from Dara. I think he made the right decision in terms of stepping into the north-south position, getting his knee on the other side of the head. But I think what stopped him from tapping there, and we'll ask him afterwards, he used his free hand to recompress the arm. If you imagine your arm's being extended like this, and now if you were to like push your hand down in the center of my arm here, that's going to push more of a bend in it there. You want to stop the full hyperextension. So he used his other arm to be able to like stop it from hyperextending at the last minute. That was a really good sequence there. I do think that Glenn's jiu-jitsu is really nice to watch, especially that setup for the triangle. The same sort of format as he had in the first round. He just committed for it quicker in the second. This could be a really exciting third round. Well, let's hope it is a really exciting third round. Not it could be.
You've built it up beautifully, Andrew. And
here's the stalemate coming
now.
They'll
dance.
3 minutes of cage wrestling.
Oh! Nice right hand followed by a left high kick. So different looks for Rafferty. There's that left head kick again, but Hardy comes charging forward and Rafferty uses that momentum to change levels and get the takedown again. Sits into half guard.
Definitely a good lesson to have learned from this. In terms of like success completion of what you hit in your fights, it starts to become your A game. For Dara Rafferty to have timed two takedowns off oncoming rushing opponents here is going to be a good thing for him to take back to the gym after this. There's some great top control position, but yes, that's what we'd like to see more of.
Oh, he's potentially slipped into a triangle here.
Both hands you'd look to get out from here, maybe back to a standing position. That's what I was saying. When he was in this standing position now, you're at much less of a threat of a triangle. But again, a lovely guard from Glenn.
Guard, yeah.
Glenn's hips are moving in such a nice way that he's always going to be a threat from this position, even though he's off his back. Some good top control from Dara here, don't get me wrong. But
using that Kimura grip, as we've seen in an earlier fight, to potentially sweep. He's
looks like a wee frame here.
But a big moment here in this fight. This could be decisive with Dara Rafferty on top of Glenn Hardy. Again, look in the hips of Glenn Hardy, constantly trying to attack.
Used the cage very nicely with his toes there as well. No,
yeah, I noticed that.
Let him away with it. It was nice.
Just looking to sit onto that right hip, and again changing the hips. Rafferty will follow them hips to try and shut down any offense from the bottom from Hardy. He has done so and reset and squared up.
This is also where Dara's having his best control times here, is when he's leaving his head directly under the chin. So he was using his head to control the posture of Glenn's head, or control the position of Glenn's head. But moving into a half guard here, and especially it's not a conventional half guard. See this shin trap? Now he's gone back into a conventional half guard, but that shin control on the calf is an annoying position to be in. Some good shots being landed here by Dara Rafferty. He's moving around looking for a pass.
The knee shield across from Hardy's trying his best to do what he can to get back up here, but all advancements have been shut down from Dara Rafferty. Great to see the growth in fighters between fights, and lucky enough we've seen him here at Euro Fighting Championship, and we have seen an incredible growth in Dara Rafferty.
Well, that's the one thing, that's the difference, you know. This is a guy, he's been coming, and everyone is welcome. Friday nights, 7 p.m. in Newry, a no-gi all levels class that I take. If people from around the north or northeast would like to come and train, it's no problem. Dara Rafferty has been there basically every single week since his last fight. I've seen him wrestling two or three times a week in the gym, training in the gi as well whenever he can. If you do not take either the positive or the negative from your fight and try and get better before your next one, you're codding yourself. You're an Instagram fighter. You want to be seen as a fighter. You don't actually want to improve as a fighter. Dara Rafferty had a bad loss in his last one. He has spent more time in the gym now, and there you get the result. Congratulations, Dara Rafferty. Glenn Hardy's guard is something that I would be oh wait, is that only the second round? No. Was that the third? Yeah, all right, never mind. Sorry. Yes, time flies here when you're having fun. But Glenn's guard is definitely something that will get him further in his amateur career. Some really great movements off his hips. And again, the same way Dara learned something from his last one, maybe Glenn learned something from this one. It was the rushing in on a couple of striking sequences that got an easier entry for Dara into the takedowns.
The judges for this battle 27, 29, 28, and 29, 28. All for the winner by unanimous decision. By